Dordogne. Dordogne is a department in southwestern France, with its prefecture in Périgueux. The department is located in the region of Nouvelle-Aquitaine between the Loire Valley and the Pyrenees and is named after the river Dordogne that runs through it. It corresponds roughly with the ancient county of Périgord. It had a population of 416,909 in 2013. The county of Périgord dates back to when the area was inhabited by the Gauls. It was originally home to four tribes. The name for four tribes in the Gaulish language was Petrocore. The area eventually became known as the county of Le Périgord and its inhabitants became known as the Périgordins. There are four Périgords in the Dordogne. The Petrocores took part in the resistance against Rome. Concentrated in a few major sites are the vestiges of the Gallo-Roman period, the gigantic ruined tower and arenas in Périgueux, the Périgord Museum's archaeological collections, villa remains in Montcaret, and the Roman tower of La Rigale Castle in Villetoureix. The earliest cluzeaux can be found throughout the Dordogne. These subterranean refuges and lookout huts were large enough to shelter entire local populations. According to Julius Caesar, the Gauls took refuge in these caves during the resistance. After Guienne province was transferred to the English crown under the Plantagenets following the remarriage of Eleanor of Aquitaine in 1152, Périgord passed by right to English suzerainty. Being situated at the boundaries of influence of the monarchies of France and England, it oscillated between the two dynasties for more than 300 years of struggle until the end of the Hundred Years' War in 1453. The county had been torn apart and, as a consequence, that modeled its physiognomy. During the calmer periods of the late 15th and early 16th centuries, the Castellan plain on the banks of the Dordogne saw a development in urban architecture. The finest Gothic and Renaissance residences were built in Périgueux, Bergerac, and Sarlat. In the countryside, the nobility erected the majority of the more than 1,200 chateaux, manors, and country houses. In the second half of the 16th century, however, the terrors of war again visited the area, as the attacks, pillaging, and fires of the wars of religion reached a rare degree of violence in Périgord. At the time, Bergerac was one of the most powerful Huguenot strongholds, along with La Rochelle. Following these wars, Périgord, fief of Henry of Navarre, was to return to the crown for good and would continue to suffer from the sudden political changes of the French nation, from the Revolution to the tragic hours of the resistance. We also encounter the memory of the region's most important literary figures, Arnaud Daniel, Bertrand de Born, Michel de Montaigne, Etienne de la Boetie, Brantôme, Fenelon, Maine de Biron, Eugene Leroy, and André Maurois, its great captains, Talleyrand, Saint-Exupéry, Biron, and even entertainer and activist Josephine Baker. A number of ruins have retained the memory of the tragedies that took place within their walls. Several of the castles and chateaux are open to visitors, some of them, such as Bordeaux and Marolles, house noteworthy collections. In addition to its castles, chateaux, churches, bastides, and cave fortresses, the Périgord region has preserved since centuries past a number of villages that still have their market halls, dovecotes, bories, churches, abbeys, and castles. Saint-Léon-sur-Vézère, Canezac, Saint-Jean-de-Colle, La Roque-Gagic, and many others contain important and visually interesting architectural examples. The old quarters of Périgueux or Bergerac have been restored and developed into pedestrian areas. A number of small towns, such as Brantôme, Issagic, Imet, and Marolles, have withstood the changes of modern times. A special mention should be made in this respect to Sarlat in its Black Périgord area. Dordogne is one of the original 83 departments created on March 4, 1790 during the French Revolution. It was created from the former province of Périgord, the county of Périgord. Its borders continued to change over subsequent decades. In 1870, shortly after France fought against Prussia in a war that the enemy was winning, a young aristocrat called Alain de Munis was savagely tortured and then burned by a crowd of between 300 and 800 people for 2 hours on 16 August in a public square in the village of Hautefay in the northwest of the department. Details of the incident remain unclear. The leading participants appear to have been drunk, and before the introduction of mass education most of the witnesses would have been unable to write down what they saw. But at some stage the victim died, and following a trial four individuals identified as culpable were in turn condemned to die by guillotine. The sentence was carried out in the same public square on February 13, 1885. It was suggested that the victim had reported the news of the war in a way that implied support for the enemy, although subsequently it became clear that his patriotic credentials were beyond reproach. It was also suggested that the mob had been antagonized when he called out, "Vive la République!" At a time when the patriotic villagers valued the imperial regime, which Parisian revolutionaries were in the process of destroying. The incident was widely reported at the time and has since been extensively researched. This summary relies on the work of Alain Corbin, a modern historian specializing in the 19th century who analyzed the incident and the mass psychology behind it. The department is part of the region of Nouvelle-Aquitaine and is surrounded by the six departments of Haute-Vienne, Corrèze, Lot, Lot-et-Garonne, Gironde, and Charente. Dordogne is the third largest department of metropolitan France. The president of the General Council is Germinal Perrault of the Socialist Party. The population peaked at 505,789 in 1851 according to that year's census. After 150 years of steady decline, it fell below 400,000 by the year 2000. This reflected the long-term population decline observed in many of the rural departments resulting from changes in agriculture and the lure of higher industrial wages available in more urbanized regions. However, during the first decade of the 21st century, the decline has been reversed. Dordogne has earned the nickname Dordogneshire for its thriving British community. The region counts between 5,000 and 10,000 British residents and 800 British entrepreneurs, drawn by a laid-back lifestyle, warm climate, and lower cost of living. The village of Imid is at the heart of the trend, with 200 British families among 2,600 inhabitants. There are more than 1,500 castles in Dordogne, making it the other chateau country, including the famous caves of Lascaux have been closed to the public, but a replica of Lascaux too is open to visitors and is a major tourist attraction. Périgueux has important Roman ruins, including an arena which is still visible inside a public park located near the town center. Thanks for watching. Don't forget like the video and don't forget to subscribe.